Hello, thanks again for joining us for another episode of Tom Talks. Today we're going to be visiting with a good friend, Dr. Fernando Nardi, Director of the Water Resources Research and Documentation Center in Perugia, Italy. We've known one another for a few years now and have worked together on a new concept to me called Story Maps. And so we're quite excited to learn more about this. Fernando is a professor of hydrology at the University in Perugia and also has taught at universities in Rome and Florence. Thanks for joining us, Fernando.
Oh, thank you, Tom. And I'm so glad that I have the chance, thank to you, to share my experience, my activities, my projects with you and everyone there in Colorado. It's really a pleasure to be hosting Tom Talks. So thank you.
Thank you. So we're going to learn more about story maps, and we thought we would start with some story maps that Fernando and his team in Perugia helped my wife Grace and I put together. We call them Grace and Tom blogs, which are a combination of stories about Italy from a blog perspective, but also embedded a lot of science and GIS exercises.
No, absolutely. So that's going to be, the goal of my short talk, trying to share with you what Tom said. It's true, it's a blog, so it's a web-based content that you can publish and share with your friends, colleagues, professionals, and clients, and anyone you work with, because it's a content, data, information sharing. But I'm going to try to convey the message that story maps are much more than a blog. So having access to the platform that is actually produced by a company called Esri that we are a partner of. So again, that's, I think, very important to share with the Tom Talks audience. This you can do yourself having access to the platform, and we are happy to give you access to the platform through the WOW Center. We have a collaboration also in which this is stated. And you can also produce other kind of topics also for your projects. So this is another one that I really like. So I hope, Tom, you agree if I show this one. The Wells of Popes and Farmers. I like this because it's water related. I'll go quick. Etruscan wells. We have water wells in Perugia. Everywhere is a water-rich area. That's why the city was built along the islot and along the fluvial valley of the Tiber River. And this one, 90 feet, 27 meters depth, well, that you can see, and you think this is like protected in an archaeological zone. You need to pay the ticket for the museum, right? Because that's real true. Oh man, you can see the feet of Tom. I took the picture. And you can see this is in a cafeteria. It's not a museum.
It's wonderful. It was amazing.
Yeah, I know. I like to make fun of ourselves. We have so plenty of these architectural, archaeological, like it's a monument that we try to protect them. Yeah, so they can you don't fall down. But you can just walk in and find these kind of features amazing in our city. It's really beautiful.
And what was amazing, that well was dug about 300 BC, over 2,000 years ago. And there it is in a coffee shop.
And it's there. And Jane, I just, again, I want to invite people to look at this story maps because I still myself like to read it, even if I was there when they were, made. And other information, again, with the goal of sharing information about the view of an American colleague coming to Perugia, but also vice versa. Tom was exchanging his knowledge and experiences with Colorado and Nebraska, where he's from, with my students, my young professional that come to Perugia, to my university, to learn how to produce story maps. So other features, again, look at this one. It's amazing. We have so many, that's actually the San Patrick well. But again, I don't want to take too much of the time because I want to focus of trying to, if Tom, you agree, this is another, that's the Tiber River. So you can see there's a river that from Perugia, from actually the source, the Monte Fumaiolo, where the Tiber River comes from, to Rome. That's actually what you see here. Is where the civilization of the Romans and the Etruscans before the Romans started. So you can see Perugia is here. That's why Perugia was built there, on top of the hills and the water flowing along the floodplain of the Tiber give birth to what everyone knows is the, you know, the Roman Empire and civilization that we're still continuing in tough times, or we try.
Yeah.
And others, this other one I like, the two seas. We have the Adriatic Sea, the Mediterranean Sea. But again, let's stop here and have the people listening to the Tom Talks exploring. So all the links about our exchanges, projects, all this is both in the Waterdog website, but also in the OWOW website, where we are about to actually publish all the story maps organized by contest, so that all the peoples, all the, you know, network partners of the WOWOW Center can really can look at and understand. I think, again, I would like to stress the importance of this effort, or showing a part of the academic and research exchange as a way for linking not just the experiences of colleagues and friends coming to Italy, but also the potential use of this technology, of this methodology we put together for linking the Tiber River Basin Agency with the Colorado Agency. We do have very diverse and different climatic and social settings, but we have the same issues. Water-related issues everywhere, floods, yeah, droughts, food security, food sustainability. I think it's enough for conveying how much passion, motivation, but also scientific and professional knowledge we have and we put. Story maps is really a good way of starting and a good way of keep going with our collaboration. I'm very thankful and very, very glad to have. So thank you, Tom.
Thank you, Fernando. And I can't agree more. This idea of a story map is just a wonderful way to provide information in an interesting and fun way, and yet very scientific and very useful. So happy to learn about this and look forward to many more years of collaboration with you.
No, absolutely. So we miss you. We miss the Colorado students in Perugia. And we are so looking forward to forget about the COVID times and come back in operations in both Colorado and Italy. So I really invite you and all your team, all your friends and colleagues in Colorado to get to know our work and come visiting us in Italy. We are open doors. You see the buildings and everyone we do in Italy. It's a pleasure for us to share it with you.
Very good. Very good. Well, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Fernando.
Thank you. See you soon,
ciao, ciao.
Everyone.
Ciao, ciao.
Ciao, ciao, ciao. Ciao. Bye. Arrivederci.